So today we are going to start with fourth experiment, that is study of magnetic materials, in which we are going to learn about what are the different magnetic materials we are using in electrical engineering applications, what are the different properties, and what are the different we are focusing the application of magnetic material. Okay, now if we talk about the magnetic material, we generally say that magnetic materials are nothing but the materials which has a magnetism or magnetic properties, and that property is not only related with attracting or attracting the metallic particles or metallic objects, but it is also related with using that magnetism, its ability to control the mechanical movement, and using it for our machineries as well as signal related applications. Okay, so this is how we can say that magnetic material plays a very important role. And as we have seen that we cannot experience or we cannot see basically the flow of current or flow of electrons, similarly we cannot see the actual magnetism or actual magnetic lines of force, but we can experience it with the help of some kind of demonstration, some kind of experiments we can observe that. So if we talk about the magnetism, what are the first two important points which are coming in your mind? Just write it down in your chat box. Aapko magnet ye naam ke naam sunne ke baad aapko kya kya yaad aata hai ya kya aapko lagta hai magnet ke bare mein? I hope I am audible to you properly, right? So first thing we can see that magnetism, jaise hi mind mein aayega aapke, first thing you will know or you will understand that is its polarity. What are the different polarities a magnetic field or a magnetic circuit has? It's N and S, definitely. After that, we also have one concept in our mind that if magnetic field is there or magnetism is there, then we have two types of magnetism. One is called as your permanent magnet and one is called as a artificial, or we can say we have electromagnetism to that particular concept. So now moving ahead with this, we have to see if we are doing the electromagnetism, making a circuit to generate electromagnetic field, then we have some kind of reversal process, or we have some magnetization as well as demagnetization, and in that we are arising to the topic called as a hysteresis loop, and how the hysteresis loop will play an important role in the machine design or machine manufacturing. Okay, we ye sari cheeze aaj hum dekhne wale hain. Now if you talk about the magnetic material, what are the different impurities inside the material, what are the what we call it as a loss of magnetism? Okay, these all things we are going to learn in today's session. So I hope you all are ready. Now see what exactly the magnetism is mean to you. Magnetism is a force, it is a force basically, and it's a available in the field. It means it is created from one end to another end and which acts on the magnetic materials. Like this particular force which is taken or which is given by this kind of solid structure, and that structure or physical device you can say is called as a magnets. Now magnet has an ability to attract the iron, steel, and it will also has a capacity to rotate so that it will be align itself with the magnetism or magnetic polarity of our earth. Okay, so that is another advantages you can say, or you can say that it is another characteristics basically. Okay, characteristics of a magnetic material, magnetic field. And because of the magnetic field and its effect, you can see that the magnetism is playing an important role in our electrical engineering industry. So now two magnets and two types, two groups. One is called as a natural magnets, or we can say permanent magnet, and another is called as an artificial magnet, where a human has a control over it, and we can decide whether the magnetic field should be there or not. Okay, so let's moving ahead with the first type, that is natural magnet. It's an iron compound, and it is a natural magnet which is very discovered long back, where some of the materials are touching to it, that particular lodestone and that particular material is attracting the similar type of material called as a natural magnet. Whereas artificial magnets is defined as a permanent magnet and temporary magnet, or we can say it as a electromagnets. That is another classification of artificial magnets. Now, if we talk about the magnets and its usability in our day-to-day life, we can see that magnets are everywhere, like in our mobile charging device. It is also in our most of the electronic devices. It is also in the compass, right? The magnetic materials are also plays important role in a fan, cooler. Jahan par bhi rotating energy hume chahiye, wahan pe ye magnetic field, magnetic effect plays a very important role. Now, if a piece of a magnetic material, say soft iron, is placed in a strong magnetic field, then it becomes magnetized, okay, because of the presence or because of the nearby availability of the magnetic field. Now, that soft iron itself is becoming a temporary magnet, and that depend on this particular diagram. If you are able to see this, I hope you are able to see the mouse pointer, okay, and as per this particular diagram, you can observe that if the magnetic field is created, that will be totally dependent on the availability of current flowing through the coil. If the current is flowing through the coil, then only the magnetic field is generated and it is being observed. If current is not flowing through it, there is a no magnetism available there because of the induction principle. Now, similarly, this same concept can be used in the electric bells as well as relays, where temporary magnetism creates a physical effect or physical event, which we call it as attraction of the plunger, or what you can say, pulling the plunger and doing the necessary action of turning on the device or turning off the device. Okay, now moving ahead with this, we are going to understand more about the materials which are used in a special operation, special application, like permanent magnets. Now, this particular permanent magnets are like, say, steel substituted for the soft iron, and the same magnetic field is applied, then it will be having its own magnetic field for some time, like steel, nickel, alnico, tungsten, and this retention will be for some longer duration. So, for example, if you are coming in a contact with this particular steel bar and you are having another magnetic field which is associated with that steel bar, then it will be providing you the retention more time. For example, it will be having some amount of magnetic field retained. Now, what do you mean by retained? Ye uske paas reh jata hai, okay? Aur wo rehne ke baad wo zyada samay tak uske paas rehta hai, and iske magnetic properties jo hai wo hame for longer duration we are able to observe, okay? Now, what exactly the molecular theory of the magnetism? ये काफी हमने स्कूल टाइम में वगैरह पढ़ा होगा आपने, आपको अगर याद आ रहा है तो. सो एवरी मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल हैज एबिलिटी टू अलाइन द डायपोल्स, ओके, मैग्नेटिक डोमेन्स बोलते हैं उसको, मैग्नेटिक डायपोल्स बोलते हैं. सो फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स आर लाइक हैविंग द मॉलिक्यूल्स विद इन देमसेल्फ एंड दे आर सिमिलरली एक्टिंग एज अ टाइनी मैग्नेट्स, ओके, लाइक यू कैन सी इन द इमेज that there is a red and blue color shown, but in the left side diagram here you can see that this particular diagram, you can have these randomly allocated loose magnetic domains, okay? So N and S polarity is there, but still it is not a linear, it is not we can say aligned, so it is in random shape and size. Now, when we take this material in contact with the magnetic field, then we can observe that these all domains are aligned by themselves or by external field, and because of the effect of magnetism, these are lined up in the series. Now, because of this crystalline structure and continuous movement of the electrons in their atoms, these all conditions are basically useful when they are magnetized. They are into the arrangement like this, and we are getting the effect of its own strength in terms of magnetic strength. Okay, so this material now become acting as a magnetic, having the magnetic capacity, and it will be able to attract or repel the magnets. Okay, so this is how we can say that this kind of magnetism is what we have seen earlier. Now, Earth's magnetic field is also aligned with our magnets. So, Earth magnetic field is also manipulating, also interacting with the magnets we are using, so that we can have a application of a magnet in the compass. So that in a compass, I hope you have seen the compass in your lifetime. To see the direction, just type yes in the chat box if you have seen, used the magnetic needle or magnetic compass. Okay, since the earth is itself is a large spinning mass, it is to produce its own magnetic field. Okay, it has a bar magnet, say for example, and for the whole Earth or a whole Earth diameter, you can say that it is divided. And as per that, if we are going near to the North Pole, the South geographical pole is coming to it, or we can say that it is showing about the South Pole, so that our magnetic needle can eventually show the right polarity after the magnetic needle's movement. Now let's see what are the different properties of magnets, magnetic materials. Okay, first is that magnets are able to create a magnetic field. The force of magnetism is also referred as a magnetic field, where the surrounding area will be influencing the magnet to create its field or create its line of force. Okay, so this particular magnet is going to create a magnetic field surrounded by it, and also it will be having its own lines of force. Yes, the magnetism. Now they are in the similar manner that they are very highly densely populated near the edge, you can say, near the corner tip of the magnet, and it will be having scattered basically when we are going away from the magnet. I hope yahan tak aapko samajh mein aaya hai. Now let's see second property. First is, we have seen that is the magnets are creating a magnetic field. That is the first property. Second property, we can say that it has an attraction property. Like magnets are in a position to attract the magnetic materials like iron, nickel, cobalt, and this capacity is more of at the higher capacity at the poles. So jahan par bhi aapka magnet jo hai wo open hota hai, wahan par iska jo capacity hai wo highest rehta hai. This is what we call it as a attraction property. Directive properties, if you talk about, if we are having our magnet kept on a open and free surface, freely hanging position, then we can say that after the steady state condition of that magnet, it is aligning itself, aligning that magnet in such a way that it will showcase the north and south polarity. Okay, so this is a directive property of a magnetic field, magnetic material. Now pole existing property, or we can say it is extending its magnetic field. If we take one magnet and divide it into two parts, one we can understand that it will be having a north polarity at the right hand side and south polarity at the left hand side. Then when we cut it, okay, or accidentally the magnetic field is broken, magnetic material is broken basically, or magnet is broken, you can say, that time whether you purposefully cut it or it is accidentally cut or broken, then it will create another set of magnet. It means it will be creating a two different magnets because of the one cut. That is a pole existing property of the magnet. Then we have is the induction property. Now induction property is something like that. When we have a magnetic field created by a magnet, then that magnetic field is going to the next level, next material, and it is attracting another materials which are coming in associated with the magnet. So ek magnet ki wajah se agar ek nail attract ho chuka hai, to uske andar jitne bhi magnetic domains hai, dipoles hai, wo bhi align honge और वो अलाइन होने के वजह से वो जो नेल है वो किसी दूसरे नेल को भी अट्रैक्ट कर सकता है, उसको भी वो मैग्नेटाइज कर सकता है। और उसी तरह से इसका जो मैग्नेटिक सर्किट है वो पूरा हो जाएगा। ओके, आगे बढ़ते हैं। नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी अगर हम देखेंगे तो काफी इम्पोर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी है, विच इज अ डी मैग्नेटाइजेशन प्रॉपर्टी। एंड इफ वी आर जस्ट नॉट taking care of a magnet, then it will lose its magnetic property. That is, if you are not using it properly, इसका मतलब क्या है कि हमारा magnets के साथ अगर हमने heating application या हमारे magnet के साथ अगर हमने hammering ये सारे operations किए तो हमारा magnet जो है वो उसकी capacity जो है magnetism जो है उसे lose कर देगा। Okay, आगे बढ़ते हैं। Property of strength. It is very important. Every magnet has a two poles, and two poles at the polarity has a equal strength. If you talk about the magnetic pole strength, then we can say that ऐसा नहीं कि north pole जो है वो ज़्यादा ताकतवान है और जो आपका south pole है वो कम ताकतवान है, ऐसा नहीं है। It's like both the polarity, both the poles has same strength. Okay, moving ahead with this, again a very important property, and we can say that this is a this property is a identifier property. I hope I am audible to you all. Just type yes in the chat box so that I can understand my audio is clear to you. Moving ahead with this, when we talk about the attraction or repulsion, that repulsion is a property of identification. Okay, it means if we have a two magnets, they can attract each other if they has a dissimilar, or we can say that unlike poles like north and south, then they will attract each other. But also happens if the magnetic material is also being attracted towards the magnet. So we cannot understand whether this material is magnet or whether this material is magnetic material. Now what is the difference between it? Magnet means it has its own capacity to attract the magnetic materials. Okay. And magnetic materials की definition क्या है? The material which is being attracted towards the magnets is called as a magnetic material. So now if both are the magnets and both are having the same polarity, then they will be experiencing a repulsion force. Repulsion force जैसे ही उन्होंने experience किया तो हमें पता चलेगा कि this is the identification property, call it as a property of attraction or रिपल्शन। आगे बढ़ते हैं सैचुरेशन प्रॉपर्टी, जिसके ऊपर हमें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें सीखनी है। दैट इज इफ अ मैग्नेट ऑफ अ हायर स्ट्रेंथ इज फर्दर सब्जेक्टेड टू मैग्नेटाइजेशन, इट मींस यू ऑलरेडी हैज अ कप ऑफ से एनी कप यू हैव एंड इन दैट कप यू ऑलरेडी पोर्ड अ वाटर एंड नाउ यू वांट टू अगेन पोर समथिंग इनसाइड इट, सो इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर दैट कप टू हैंडल दैट। ओके, and to understand this concept you can see that if we are magnetizing more than its capacity, then our magnetic material will be considering that it is a saturation. Okay, maine aapka aaj lecture jo hai wo samjho 1 ghante ki jagah pe 2 ghante liya ya 3 ghante ki jagah pe 5 ghante liya, so what happen, your brain will feel sleepy and you will feel that सर अभी बहुत हो गया, सो समथिंग लाइक दैट हैपन विद दिस मैग्नेट। ओके, सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ सैचुरेशन, मैग्नेटिक सैचुरेशन, सो इट विल नेवर एक्वायर मोर मैग्नेटिज्म ड्यू टू द ऑलरेडी सैचुरेटेड। एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम यू कैन सी हियर इज कॉल्ड एज अ हिस्टेरिसिस लूप, वेयर वी कैन सी दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज बीइंग एक्वायर्ड and it is like it is a particular magnetic field is being accumulated. Beyond that, the strength of the magnetic signal is not going to increase and the magnetic field area is also not going to increase. So this is what we call it as the hysteresis loop. Okay, so let's moving ahead with this. This can be also leading if the boundaries of this hysteresis loop is being able to increase. Okay, अगर इसको increase करना चाहा हमने तो हमें इसको increase करना है तो हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ ध्यान दीजिए सिर्फ material change करके ही हम इस particular loop को change कर सकते हैं. And for your information, if you are having using if you are using this particular magnetic material for your electric machine, you can say, or electric applications, then we are looking for the amount of energy which is used by this kind of material within the limit. Say for example, जितना ये particular जो कर्व आपको दिख रहा है, ये ऊपर जाने वाला मतलब मैग्नेटाइजेशन, पीछे आने वाला मतलब डीमैग्नेटाइजेशन, तो इन दोनों के बीच में जितना भी एरिया दिख रहा है आपको, दैट इज अ बेसिकली लॉस फॉर अस। तो ये जितना छोटा हो सकता है, जितना कम हो सकता है, उतना हमारे लिए अच्छा है, और उसके लिए हमें अलग अलग मटेरियल्स का इस्तेमाल करना जरूरी होता है। ओके, आगे बढ़ते हैं। व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट दिस मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स, different classification. Okay, let's see. Before that, I would like to ask you to draw this diagram. Okay, I'll just zoom in for it so that you can easily see it in the mobile phone if you are logging with the mobile phone. Okay, is it visible now? So just draw it, and when you're done, just type done in the chat box. Okay, so I hope you have done with it. So now moving ahead, I hope everyone done it, right? Perfect. आगे बढ़ते हैं। क्लासिफिकेशन, फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल, पैरामैग्नेटिक मटेरियल एंड डायमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल सब्सटेंस, वी कैन से इट। क्या होता है ये, आगे देखते हैं। सब्सटेंस विच आर स्ट्रॉन्गली अट्रैक्टेड बाय मैग्नेट्स आर नोन एज फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस, लाइक आयरन, निकल, कोबाल्ट एंड देयर अलॉयज। पैरामैग्नेटिक इज लाइक सब्सटेंसेस विच आर स्लाइटली अट्रैक्ट, और वी कैन से अट्रैक्टेड बाय द मैग्नेट्स, लाइक एल्यूमिनियम, प्लैटिनियम, magnesium, manganese, and diamagnetics are like those substances which are repelled by magnets of powerful strength, and they are not it is not something which is attracting the magnet, so it's called as a diamagnetic substance, like copper, boron, zinc and silicon. Okay, moving ahead, just draw this diagram in your notebook. Okay, done everyone. Moving to the next, that is application of magnetism, where we are using the magnetic material, magnets. Basically, one very common example you say, that is a speaker. Magnetic field is used with the help of current carrying wire in a magnetic field, and then it is converting the electrical energy into the sound energy by the creating a appropriate vibrations. Okay, this is how the speaker is basically working, where we have a voice coil, we have a magnet, strong magnetic field, and then a diaphragm, and according to the vibrations created in the diaphragm, the energy is converted into the voice or a sound waves basically. Okay, then second one is a hard drive is like it's a data storage device, and the plate which is used inside it is having a thin magnetic coating. Now, magnetic coating is like having its zeros and ones in the very small areas in the form of north and south pole, and then that magnetic field is basically being stored as a sequence of the data, and then the head where the magnetic field is being created or retrieved is being used in the hard drive. So let's see when we use exactly these magnetic materials for our electrical application, like a transformer core. So transformer core is basically providing a magnetic path for the magnetic flux which is being created by your primary winding, and then that flux is linking with the secondary winding. Okay, so this particular magnetic flux has a path, jo road use milta hai jane ke liye, wo core se milta hai, core jo hai वो आपके मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल से बनता है। उसके कुछ एग्जांपल्स है, जैसे सिलिकॉन स्टील, विच इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फेमस यू कैन से मटेरियल फॉर मैग्नेटिक कोर। अनदर इज फेरिट सिरेमिक्स, हॉट रोल्ड स्टील, कोल्ड रोल्ड स्टील ग्रेन, ग्रेन ओरिएंटेड स्टील। सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स ऑफ मटेरियल्स इन द इलेक्ट्रिकल इंडस्ट्रीज। ओके, देन वी हैव मोटर्स। अगेन, मोटर कोर इज बेसिकली made up by your steel, magnetic silicon steel, which is one of the most widely used material for the electrical industries. Moving ahead with this contactor, again using a magnetic field, magnetic material as a solenoid inside it. So this attraction is communicating with our electrical signals, and the magnetic field is being activated, and then it is connecting the electrical contacts, so that it also provide a contactor and ability to understand our electrical signals and perform the electrical connections. So I hope यहाँ तक आपको applications समझ में आए हैं, right? So we'll stop here for today. Now what you are supposed to do with the today's information? What is the what is the way of writing the assignment? Okay, that is I am sharing with you. First of all, you have to give a title, that is study of data sheet or study of the magnetic materials. What exactly do you mean by magnetism? Then you have to give types of magnets. Then in the types of magnets, you can elaborate all the classification, what exactly it is. Then we are going for properties, okay, properties of the magnetic material, magnetic characteristics, उसके units क्या होते हैं, like residual magnetic flux density क्या होता है, cohesive force क्या होता है, maximum energy product क्या होता है, ये सारी चीजें आपको वहाँ पे क्या करना है, introduce करना है. Then you have to refer the magnetic materials data sheet को refer करना है. And by using the data sheet, you will understand what are the different magnetic materials are there, which can be helpful in our motors, transformers, electronic devices, जहाँ जहाँ पर भी हम इसका इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. Okay, तो ये सारी चीजें हैं जो आप ये experiment के file में या experiment के write up में लिख सकते हैं. सो आई होप यहाँ तक आप सभी को क्लियर हो गया है. डेटा शीट का मैं एक सैंपल आपको दिखाता हूँ, सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. यू कैन गो विद एनी अदर मटेरियल ऑल्सो, लाइक एनी अदर कंपनी ऑल्सो. दिस इज अ TDK मटेरियल्स. तो इन है फेराइट मैग्नेट्स, फेराइट FB सीरीज. देन यू गेट ऑल द प्रोडक्ट नेम, फीचर, मटेरियल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, बेसिक फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. These all details are there in the data sheet. Okay, so data sheet is providing all the details of this magnetic material, and this magnetic material is having another graph where the distribution chart is also shown of its capacity, and then you can see this table where we can have a different classification of the type of the magnetic characteristics and its own values. Okay. तो कौन सा मटेरियल कहाँ पे इस्तेमाल करना है, ये सारी चीजें आपको यहाँ पर पता चलेगी. एंड देन इफ यू आर यूजिंग दैट मैग्नेट फॉर डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशन, उसका साइज शेप क्या है, ये सारी चीजें हम यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं. ओके, सो ये डेटा शीट को आप रेफर करना है. डेटा शीट में बहुत सारे डिटेल्ड में आपको इंफॉर्मेशन दिया गया रहता है, उसको रेफर करना है. ओके, सो आज के लिए इतना ही. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टॉप हियर फॉर द टुडेज सेशन, एंड मेक श्योर यू सबमिट योर एक्सपेरिमेंट असाइनमेंट नंबर 4.